Hey, what's up, guys? It's Corey, Videolog 17. How do you do the wheel properly? So, a lot of you know that I always kind of joke around and say, how about grab a $10 wheel from Walmart, and that's your main thing to build your abs. Over the years, I've pretty much lived on the wheel. And I think that has a lot to do with the thickness of how my stomach muscles got when I was getting ready for shoots and shows and things like that. So, I've been using the one that's a little bit bigger lately because it changed the angle a little bit. But the key to it is that I want to make sure people are using it correctly. When you get set up to do a wheel, you almost already want your back humped up. The problem is a lot of people start it like this, so when they go down, it's all lower back because you're not even in the right angle. When you start with it up high like this, then when you come out, you're flat and then back up to that position. And so when you're opening it up, it's targeting right here and then back. When you're already arched like this, your body's not in the correct position to even utilize your stomach muscles. And so, with this one, I'll either grab here or if I actually put my hands in this thing, you go out and then back up right to the position you're in. Out, back up to the position you're in. And so literally, if you're a person that's done a lot of crunch type of movements and you switch to the wheel, your abs will thicken up. And you gotta remember that not just working for tone, but build for thickness and a little bit of mass in your stomach too. So as you get leaner, they like really stick out of your stomach. And so the appeal and the look is a little bit sharper. And so that's how you properly do the wheel. Thanks. Hey, what's up, guys? It's Corey, Videolog 17. How do you do the wheel properly? So a lot of you know that I always kind of joke around and say, how about grab a $10 wheel from